Brothers and sisters, the Lord Jesus Christ is coming. He is coming. He is coming. He's coming soon. His return is so imminent. He is coming at any moment. He has been giving me so much confirmation, and I'm just exhilarated. Like, I'm so excited. I'm so happy. I'm so ready to go home and be with the Lord, y'all. He gave me 3 confirmations in 1 day. The other day, I was at the lake for my daughter's birthday. And we were at the lake and we was just, you know, just looking at the scenery. It was so beautiful. It was so sunny outside. It was just perfect. So I'm like, okay, let me take a picture of the sky. So I took a picture of the sky. And this, the picture that you guys are looking at, is how the picture turned out. Now, I didn't edit this. I didn't change the color or anything. Literally, I took a picture of the sky and it turned out blue. And I can just see his glory just manifesting, just exuding from this picture. And I was just like, oh my goodness, Lord, like, this is a sign. This is a sign from heaven. And you know what? He gave me the scripture in Mark 13, verses 24. He said, but in those days after that tribulation, the sun shall be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars of heaven shall fall, and the powers that are in heaven shall be shaken. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. And then shall he send his angels, and shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from the uttermost part of the earth to the uttermost part of heaven. Now, after that, y'all, like, I'm telling you, the Lord just began to show me more confirmation at this lake. And I'm just like, Lord. So the second confirmation, me and my kids, we saw a bald eagle, like, literally flying over us. And I'm just like, Lord, for real? An eagle? This eagle was huge, y'all. I never seen an eagle like that close up. But he was huge. His wings was huge. And I tried to capture a picture of this eagle. The picture that you're looking at now is the best that I could get. But y'all, the Lord has given me signs. And he also led me to Isaiah 40, verses 31. And they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint. Brothers and sisters, the Lord is telling us that we've been waiting on him, y'all. Many of us have been getting weary. We've been tired. We've been getting so many attacks, going through so much warfare, all type of stuff. And I know many of us is just ready for the Lord to come back. And in this scripture, he was just giving me a different revelation on it. He's showing us that, yes, if you wait upon me, I will renew your strength. You will mount up with wings as eagles. So the Lord is showing us that soon, because of our waiting, because of our patience, because of our endurance, soon we are going to mount up. We are going to be caught up with the Lord, y'all. We are going to be flying in that sky to meet our Lord in the air. Glory to God. I am so excited, y'all. I don't know if y'all hear the excitement in my voice. There's such an urgency in my spirit. There's such a just a great anticipation for the Lord to come back, y'all. I'm so serious. And he's showing us so many signs. I also want to show you this next picture. The very same day, the Lord showed me this next picture. And I was at the lake. I was still at the lake. This was the last confirmation. He gave me 3 confirmations all in one day. I was not looking for this confirmation. I had just went to the lake with my children, you know, for my daughter's birthday, and we just wanted to go just get away from everything and just really just get that serene time with the Lord and just basking in his presence and just seeing, you know, his creation and just being at peace and, you know, and so I wasn't looking for any of this, y'all. And this was the picture. Me and my kids, we were getting ready to go, and we were walking down this very narrow path. And you know, he just began to show me, you know, like, this is the narrow path. Continue on this narrow path, my daughter. Continue on this narrow path, because at the end, we are almost at the end. At the end is your reward. If you endure until the end, you will be rewarded greatly. And he also led me to, what was that scripture, Lord? I just missed my page. I had another scripture for you guys. But it's basically telling us, you know, to stay on the narrow path, because many, many will try to find it, but they will not be able to find it. They will not be able to find it. Many find it, but are not able to stay on the narrow path, you know? And I know y'all know what scripture I'm talking about, but the Lord is telling us, y'all, stay on this narrow path. The race is almost over. Prepare, saints. Prepare, saints. The Lord Jesus is coming. I feel him in my spirit so strongly. And I really wanted to share this with you guys. Now, brothers and sisters, this last picture is not a picture that I took. I found this picture on Facebook, and it really stirred me up so greatly, because just a couple days ago, the Lord gave my daughter, my 8-year-old daughter, a dream. And in the dream, she heard the sound of the trumpet playing. It was sounding in her dream. And she was telling me how it sounded. She was telling me how it was stopping, and then it'll start back up again. And she heard it. It was, you know, the sound of the trumpet. She knew. She knew. She knew that sound. And she was telling me. And I come across this picture. And once again, confirmation from the Lord.
He's coming.
The trumpet, Jesus, y'all. The trumpet is about to sound. The Lord is about to descend from heaven. He said in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 16, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet our Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. We are going home, y'all. We are going home. I don't know about y'all, but I'm ready for my glorified body. I'm ready. I'm tired of, you know, all of this pain and sickness. I'm tired of all of these attacks and all of this warfare. I'm tired of the heaviness. I'm tired of the temptations. I'm tired of the trials. And I know that it's all working together for our good. We know that going through these things is shaping our character and forming us into the image of Christ, more into his image and his likeness, you know. But it gets weary, y'all. I know. I understand. Please believe me. I understand it. It gets weary. It gets tiresome. But I just want to encourage y'all. You know, I wanted to share this with y'all because I was thinking about sharing these pictures, you know, when the Lord first gave me these pictures. And I'm just like, you know, might just keep it for myself. But after I saw this picture with this person or this angel in the sky blowing the trumpet, I'm like, oh man, this is just way too much confirmation. The Lord is showing us many signs in the sky. He said that there would be signs in the heaven and in the earth. There would be wonders in the heavens and signs in the earth, he said. You know, he's pouring out his spirit in these last days upon all flesh. People are having dreams and visions. I've been having dreams and visions. My kids, my daughter has been having dreams and visions. The Lord has given her a dream about heaven. Man, all type of prophetic stuff. And these are the signs. These are the signs that he's showing us that will precede his coming. It will precede his coming. So I just wanted to encourage y'all. I love y'all. Get ready. Get prepared. Get in that set place. Make sure your heart is right. Forgive. Love. Whatever you need to do, get your house in order, because he's coming. Get ready.